On August the 4th, 1976, six universities sporting NCAA independent men's basketball programs bonded to form a new league called the Sun Belt Conference. Those six programs to form the original Sun Belt lineup were from five states with major regional centers: Georgia State University in Atlanta, Georgia; Jacksonville University in Jacksonville, Florida; the University of New Orleans in New Orleans, Louisiana; University of North Carolina, Charlotte in Charlotte, North Carolina; University of South Alabama in Mobile, Alabama; and the University of South Florida in Tampa, Florida. These six schools competed in four men's sports: soccer, basketball, golf, and tennis. In its first season as a league, the Sun Belt had success, with North Carolina Charlotte winning its regular season and tournament titles before advancing to the NCAA Final Four. Along the way, it toppled powers like Michigan and Syracuse, with a future NBA player named Cedric Cornbread Maxwell, an eventual first-round pick of the Boston Celtics. After 3 years, two more schools joined the Sun Belt. UAB and VCU came on board for the 1979-80 season. The innovative Sun Belt created one of the first in-house regional television networks to show a conference game of the week starting in January of 1978. In 1979, the Sun Belt became another leader when it became the first conference to sign a long-term agreement with the then-new ESPN cable network that launched in September of 1979. The Sun Belt also encouraged its inaugural members to play in the largest basketball facility in its city, so Georgia State played most of its home games in the Omni, the 16,500-seat home of the NBA's Atlanta Hawks. The first Sun Belt Conference tournament was located in the Charlotte Coliseum. After a five-hour meeting that ended at 4:40 p.m. on a hot August day, GSU became a Sun Belt member. Each of the six schools was to pay $10,000 to become a member of this new league. The criteria they decided upon for members was major, urban, state-supported, non-football universities. On October the 11th, Sun Belt picked Vic Bubas as its first commissioner. The new 49-year-old commissioner was a big name, as he was the first person to ever play in and coach in a Final Four. Bubas took Duke from a regional school to a national school. Bubas helped get Charlotte as the host of the first Sun Belt Conference basketball championship and pushed to get every game on cable TV in that 1976-77 season. In the first week of January 1977, Georgia State hosted the Jacksonville University Dolphins at the Panther Pit, or what is currently known as our GSU Sports Arena. It was a record-setting night as Georgia State won 85-62 behind 6'2" senior George Popgun Pendleton, setting a school record with 42 points. Pendleton that night hit 18 of 27 field goal attempts. Remember, there was no three-point shot yet, and he still broke the mark by 1 point. Georgia State had some early opportunities for success as the Panther soccer program was established and winning. In its first 5 years in the Sun Belt, GSU played in the conference tournament championship game three times and finished third once. GSU had 10 players earn all Sun Belt Conference honors during those 5 years. GSU did not win a conference championship in either of these spring sports. The men's tennis team had its ups and downs with a pair of 16-8 and 15-9 seasons, plus seasons with records of 2-13 and 3-17. While not a part of the inaugural 1976-77 year, men's cross-country coach Bruce Labuddy quickly got the Panthers off and running. He won the 1979 Sun Belt Coach of the Year honor in the year that Georgia State played host to the conference championship. The team had a second-place finish and two third-place finishes during its Sun Belt tenure.